Hello everyone, I'm Nima and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the first video of my culinary math series. And you may be wondering, why am I making several videos about culinary math? Well, in my opinion, it's very, very important to know the basics of culinary math whenever you want to cook something in the kitchen, because it would really help you to have a better understanding of how much ingredients you have, how much ingredients you're adding to your food. And later on, you will understand exactly what I'm talking about right here. And it would really help you to have consistency in what you do. It would really help you to have the same product over and over again. And using culinary math, you can basically convert different units. You can standardize your recipes. You can use standardized recipes. And what is a standardized recipe? It's basically any recipe which all the ingredients has been used by volume or weight. Volume and weight, actually. Yeah, but both of them, volume and weight. And what do I mean by that? Well, your recipe may be calling for, let's say, 4 ounces of small diced onion. This is standardized because it's asking for 4 ounces of small diced onion. Its weight, it has been measured before, right? But if your recipe calls for half of onion, small diced, this is not standardized, because half of onion, the half of onion that you have may be smaller or bigger than the half of onion that I have. So this is not standardized. And let's say we both have the same recipe, and the recipe calls for half of onion, small dice. The final product that you have, it's totally different than the final product that I have, because we don't know how much that half of onion is. You may be using a big onion and half of that is like 8 ounces of onion, but I might use a smaller onion, which half of that, which is like three ounces. So this is not standardized. And it's very, very important to use standardized recipes whenever you want to cook something. So in this video, we are talking about pounds and ounces. But what is a pound? Pound is basically a unit of measuring mass and weight. And same for ounces. Ounces is basically the same thing, a unit of measuring mass or weight. But what is the difference between these two? So pound is basically bigger, and we would use pound for heavier things, heavier ingredients, but ounce is basically smaller. And this is basically compared to each other. So ounce is smaller than a pound, pound is bigger than an ounce. And we would use ounce for like smaller, for lighter ingredients, for lighter things. And an example of each of these, basically 3 potatoes, like 3 apples, 3 oranges, 3 bananas is basically roughly a pound. But an example of an ounce, basically 1 slice of bread is an ounce. And so in one pound, there are 16 ounces. And this is something that you should remember. This is something that you should memorize, that you should know. There are 16 ounces in 1 pound. And let's say, oh, that's a nice, no, it's not. I thought that was a nice circle, but I noticed it wasn't. So let's say this is 1 pound. This is 1 pound. There are 16 ounces in this, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Each of these is basically 1 ounce. So there are 16 ounces in a pound. As I said, this is something that you should remember. There are 16 ounces in a pound. All right, so now we would convert different units. And whenever you convert something, you basically either multiply or divide. And right here, as you see, the ratio is basically 1 to 16. In every pound, there are 16 ounces. So if we want to convert pounds to ounces, so pounds to ounces, it's basically how many? 1 pound, 16. So the ratio is basically 1 to 16. And if you want to convert pounds to ounces, let's say, yeah, so 1 pound is 16 ounces. How much is 2 pounds? So you have 1 pound is 16 ounces. 2 pounds, you would basically multiply 16 times 2. As I said, it's either multiplication or division. So right here, you have 16, you have 2 pounds. How many ounces? 16 times 2 is 32. There you go. 32 ounces. It's basically like that. Let's say you want how many Yeah, how many ounces is in 3 pounds? So 3 times 16, 48, right? Just like that. 3 pounds is 48 ounces. It's basically so easy. However many pounds you have, multiply by 16 and then you will have your ounces. Now, how do we convert ounces to pounds? So it's basically so easy, the exact same process, but as I said, it's either multiplication or division. So last time we multiplied by 16, now we have to divide by 16. So ounces to pounds. So it's basically 16 ounces in 1 pound. Now the ratio is 16 to 1. It's not 1 to 16, remember? So let's say you have, let's say you have 16 ounces. How many pounds is that? So you would basically divide this by 16. 16 divided by 16 is 1 pound. Let's say you have 32 ounces. How much is that? So 32 divided by 16 is 2 pounds. You see how it goes? Basically divide however many ounces you have by 16, and then you will have the pounds right here. It's basically so easy. As I said, either multiplication or division, you would either multiply by 16 if you're converting pounds to ounces, but if you're converting ounces to pounds, you would basically divide by 16. Okay, so this is basically a recap of this whole video. If you want to convert pounds to ounces, you would basically multiply however many pounds you have by 16, and then you will get the ounces. So 1 times 16 is 16, 2 times 16 is 32, 3 times 16 is 48, easy as that. Ounce to pounds, basically the same thing, but you would basically divide however many ounces you have by 16, and then you will get the pounds. So 16 divided by 16 is 1, 32 divided by 16 is 2, 48 divided by 16 is 3, easy as that. And yeah, so this was the whole video basically. Thank you for watching. I hope you actually learned what I was trying to say. If you want to support me, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure to like my videos as you watch them. Thank you, and until the next video, I will see you all later.